finish the construction. The businesses are going out of business while they're waiting to get this done.
And there is no end in sight for the construction clogging traffic along Fort Myers Beach. This is the second winter tour season, which orange cones are as prevalent as seashells.
The widening of Estero Boulevard takes up a good chunk of the only road on and off the island. NBC2 investigator David Hodges found out construction is behind schedule and could continue well into peak season.
Store owners here are unified in telling me that this construction is impacting their bottom lines yet again. And now for the second time during the busiest months of the year, they're stuck with this. Beach weather can be tough on bikes.
Beach rusts chains, ruins bicycles.
Just like Estero Boulevard construction can be corrosive to business at Island Cycles in Fort Myers Beach.
We know it's for the good, right? But, you know, let's be honest, man, this is killing everybody. Everybody is suffering from this.
About four stores have closed on Estero Boulevard this year, according to the Greater Fort Myers Beach Chamber of Commerce. Although road construction isn't the only factor, it's taking the brunt of the blame.
Finish the construction. The businesses are going out of business while they're waiting to get this done.
It's going to be wider and it's going to be so beautiful when it's all done, but it's definitely hurting the businesses right now.
It's not without cost to taxpayers, too. The road improvement project alone is estimated to cost $70 million, but that's just an estimate. Now the original estimated completion date is also changing. This is where the project was supposed to end this year, Lover's Lane, the end of 2016. It was all supposed to be done originally, but now as you can see, the construction equipment is still out. It's not even an active construction site at this point. According to the project spokesperson, it might not be finished until March.
Huh? Carbon fiber?
Impacting season at Island Cycles once again.
It's an inconvenience to the customer, it's an inconvenience to us, okay? How am I supposed to put a person on a bike?
I'm told one of the reasons for the delays is because of the utility companies involved, like Comcast and FPL. During Hurricane Matthew, they had to go over to the East Coast, so delays caused by hurricane season are now going well into the dry season. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm David Hodges.